go. This is the testing room for my very latest and greatest invention, television chocolate.
But what is television chocolate?
And it's dear child, stop interrupting me. It works by television. Now, I only television myself. I suppose it's all right in small doses, but children never seem to be able to take it in small doses. They want to sit there all day long, staring at the screen.
That's me.
Shut up, Mike.
Thank you. Now, the very first time I saw ordinary television working, I was struck by a tremendous idea. If a photograph could be broken up into millions of pieces, and the pieces sent whizzing through the air until they hit an antenna, and then they end up at the other end of the screen. Now, why couldn't I send a real bar of chocolate, sent whizzing through the air into millions of pieces, and then ended up on the other end, all ready to be eaten?
Impossible.
Think so? Why don't we send a bar of chocolate from one end to the other? By television. Bring me that chocolate, please. Now, it has to be big, because whenever you send something by chocolate, it always comes out much smaller than what it was. No. You there, my TV. Stand back. You're too close. There are dangerous rays coming out of that thing, and they'll break you up to millions of tiny pieces in 1 second. All right. Switch on, please.
The chocolate is gone.
It's gone. It's starting. It's being scattered into millions of pieces of overhead. Of forward.
Just a picture on a television screen.
It's a miracle.
Just imagine it. When I start selling this across the country, a commercial will flash onto the screen and a voice will say, "Eat Wonka's chocolates. They're the best in the world. If you don't believe us, try one for yourself now."
But Mr. Wonka, could you send other things through the air in the same way? Like a person? Could you send them from place to place too?
A person? Are you off your rocker?
But could it be done?
Good heavens, child, I really don't know. Yes, I guess it could. Of course it could. Though I wouldn't like to risk it, though. It might have some very nasty results.
Well, B, I'm going to be the first person to see my television.
No.
Mike, stop! You're going to be turned to a million pieces!
Alligator.
No, he's not! Well, he sure is taking a heck of a long time to come out.
We shall have to hope for the best. We must pray that your little boy will come out unharmed on the other end.
Yeah.
You must watch the television screen. He may come through at any minute.
Oh, yes. Is this okay? He's shrunk!
Well, of course he's shrunk. What did you expect?
What? No, you're not watching television. I'm going to blow the window out the window the moment we get home.
Gene, how will Michael ever grow back again?
Well, small boys are extremely springy and elastic, so maybe we'll stretch him out if we push and put him on a special machine I have for testing the tough stretchiness of chewing gum.
Well, how far do you think he'll stretch?
Maybe miles. Anyways, he'll be awfully thin. But out of the mug with all my super vitamin candy. It contains all the vitamins from A to Z. Mr. TV, send these orders to the Boobaloobas over there and no one shall worry. They all come out of the wash, you know, every one of them.
Once you listen to me, what do you get from a lot of TV? A pain in the neck and an IQ of 3. Why don't you try simply reading a book?
orphan, you just not bear to look. You get no commercials. Oompa, loompa, doompa dee da. If you're not greedy, you will go far. You will live in happiness too, like me. Oompa, oompa, loompa, oompa dee doo.